What is up, everyone, and welcome back to Ton Does Linux and More. It has been an absolutely massive week in the Linux world. Seriously, my head is still spinning. We've got everything from a brand new operating system from a major player to some serious drama in the kernel development world, and a ton of updates that are going to change how you use your Linux machine. So grab your coffee, or your tea, or whatever you drink, and let's dive into the biggest Linux news from the first week of September 2025. You are not going to want to miss this one. All right, first up, let's talk about the heart of it all, the Linux kernel. And boy, is there a lot to talk about. The biggest news that's got everyone buzzing is a new feature planned for Linux 6.18 called Sheaves. Now, I know what you're thinking. What in the world are sheaves? Well, in simple terms, it's a new, smarter way for the kernel to handle memory allocation. Think of it like a super efficient caching system for the slub allocator, which is the part of the kernel that manages memory for various tasks. This is being spearheaded by a SUSE engineer, Vlastimil Babka, and it promises some serious performance boosts. We're talking cheaper and faster allocations, better recycling of memory, and even pre-allocation support for tasks that can't afford to wait. The name itself is pretty cool. They're calling the per CPU caches Sheaves and the per NUMA node cache a barn. So we're farming for performance. This is a big deal for anyone who needs their system to be as fast and efficient as possible, especially with modern multi-core processors. But that's not all. We also saw the 1.0.0 release of the Linux Kernel Runtime Guard, or LKRG. This is a huge milestone for Linux security. LKRG is a kernel module that provides real-time integrity checking and exploit detection. Hitting version 1.0 means it's now considered stable and ready for wider adoption. So, for all you security-conscious users out there, this is definitely something to keep an eye on. And in other kernel news, Linux 6.17 RC5 was released, and it comes with some much-needed stability fixes for the open-source Nuvo driver for NVIDIA GPUs. So if you're running an NVIDIA card with open-source drivers, you should see a more stable experience soon. On the flip side, Linux 6.15 has officially reached its end of life. So if you're still on that version, it's time to upgrade to 6.16 to keep getting those important security updates. And now for a bit of drama. Linus Torvalds himself has been making waves this week. He's getting pretty fed up with low-quality AI-generated code being submitted to the kernel. He was quoted saying, "Can we please stop this automated idiocy?" So, it looks like the kernel development community is going to be cracking down on AI-generated patches. A good reminder that human expertise and quality control are still king in the world of open-source development. And finally, a critical security vulnerability, CVE-2025-39733, was discovered in kernels up to 6.15.9 and 6.16.0. It's a privilege escalation vulnerability, which is pretty serious. So again, make sure you're keeping your systems updated. Now, let's talk about the distros that bring the kernel to life. And this week, we had a major one. Linux Mint 22.2 Zara is officially out, and let me tell you, it is packed with new features. First off, it's an LTS release, so it'll be supported all the way until 2029. It's based on Ubuntu 24.04 and comes with the new Linux kernel 6.14. But the real stars of the show are the desktop improvements. The Sticky Notes app now has rounded corners and can even be synced with an Android app called Stinky Notes. The login screen has a slick new blur effect and support for user avatars. And Hypnotics, the TV streaming app, now has a theater mode and a borderless mode for a more immersive experience. But the biggest new feature is a brand new X app called Thingwit. This is a dedicated fingerprint authentication app that lets you use your fingerprint for the screensaver, sudo commands, and even admin apps. This is a huge step forward for usability and security in Linux Mint. And for all you theming fans, Mint 22.2 now has better compatibility with libedweta apps, so they'll follow your system theme and accent colors. It's a small touch, but it makes a big difference in the overall look and feel of the desktop. And it's not just Mint. Debian 13.1 was also released this week. This is the first point release for Debian 13 Trixie, and it's packed with bug fixes and security updates. So, if you're a Debian user, make sure you update your system to get all the latest improvements. And speaking of updates, there were some issues with Ubuntu 24.04.3 LTS this week. Some users were having trouble with security updates and system installations between September 5th and 8th. So if you ran into any problems, that's why. But it looks like things are back to normal now. And finally, for those of you who like a lightweight and simple desktop experience, Linux Lite 7.6 was also released this week. It's based on Ubuntu 24.04.3 and comes with a curated selection of updated software. It's a great option for older hardware or for anyone who just wants a no-frills Linux experience. All right, let's zoom in a little closer and talk about the desktops themselves. And the biggest news here is that the GNOME 49 release candidate is out. And it comes with a pretty big change. They're re-enabling X11 support in GDM by default. Now for those of you who have been following along, you'll know that the GNOME team has been pushing hard for Wayland. But it seems like there are still some compatibility issues that are holding things back. So, for now, they're taking a step back and making sure that everyone has a stable and reliable experience, whether they're on Wayland or X11. The final release of GNOME 49 is just around the corner, so we'll see what other surprises they have in store for us. But the really bombshell news this week comes from the KDE camp. They've just announced the alpha release of KDE Linux. Yes, you heard that right. KDE is building its own operating system. Now, this isn't just another Arch-based distro. It's a completely new take on what a Linux distribution can be. It has an immutable base OS, which means the core system is read-only, making it super stable and secure. It doesn't have a traditional package manager. Instead, it uses KDE Builder and Flatpak for all your software needs. And it's built on modern technologies like BTRF, Wayland, and Pipewire. The goal here is to create a reference implementation of the KDE desktop, a showcase of what's possible with KDE software. It's still in alpha, so it's not for everyone just yet. But it's a hugely exciting development for the KDE community and for the Linux world as a whole. And don't worry, KDE Neon isn't going anywhere, at least for now. And speaking of KDE, the development of KDE Plasma 6.5 is well underway. They're adding support for GPU underlays in KWin, which should improve performance and reduce power consumption. And they're also working on a more granular way to manage Flatpak permissions. So lots of good stuff coming soon from the KDE team. And of course, we can't forget about Cinnamon 6.4, which is the default desktop environment in the new Linux Mint 22.2. It's a polished and refined experience that's perfect for anyone who wants a traditional yet modern desktop. And finally, a quick shout out to some of the app updates we saw this week. LibAdwaita now has better theme support, Hypnotics has some great new features, and there's a new fingerprint authentication app called Fingwit. It's great to see so much innovation happening at every level of the Linux ecosystem. All right, let's talk about the hardware that powers our Linux machines, and this week we saw a flurry of driver updates. First up, NVIDIA released a new driver, version 580.82.07. This one is particularly interesting because it brings support for NVIDIA Smooth Motion to GeForce RTX 40 series GPUs. So, if you've got a high-end NVIDIA card, you should see smoother video playback and a more fluid desktop experience. And for those of you who prefer the open source route, the Nouveau driver also got some love this week. The latest release candidate for Linux 6.17 includes some major stability fixes that address those annoying GPU fault recovery bugs. So if you've been having trouble with your NVIDIA card and the Nouveau driver, this update should make a big difference. But the really exciting news in the hardware world is the upcoming support for next-generation webcams. The Linux 6.18 kernel is expected to include support for eUSB 2v2, which is a new standard that allows for much higher data rates over USB 2.0. We're talking up to 4.8 gigabit second, which is double the conventional speed. This is going to enable a new generation of high-resolution laptop webcams, so you can finally say goodbye to those grainy, low-quality video calls. And of course, we can't forget about AMD. The initial driver updates for the Linux 6.18 AMD GPU driver have been submitted. The focus this time is on power management and display handling, so you can expect better battery life and a more stable display experience on your AMD-powered machines. And in a blast from the past, the vintage ATI R300 GPU is still getting driver updates. It's amazing to see the open-source community keeping older hardware alive and well. It's a testament to the power and flexibility of Linux. And finally, a bit of a sad note for our 32-bit users. Mozilla has confirmed that it will be ending Firefox support for 32-bit Linux systems in September 2026. It's the end of an era, but it's also a necessary step as the industry moves towards a 64-bit future. And now for my favorite part of the show, the community highlights. This is where we celebrate the amazing people and projects that make the Linux community so special. And this week, the biggest highlight is undoubtedly the KDE Linux Alpha release. This is a massive undertaking by the KDE community, and it's a testament to their passion and dedication. It's a project that's been in the works for a while, and it's finally starting to bear fruit. So, a huge congratulations to everyone involved. And on a smaller scale, we saw a cool new utility called Shimmer. It's a simple tool for controlling the backlight and LEDs on your Linux device, and it's a great example of how a single developer can create something useful and share it with the community. And for all you enterprise users, there was a great article this week highlighting the top 7 free Odoo apps for Linux. Odoo is a powerful open-source ERP system, and it's great to see more and more businesses adopting it. And finally, a quick shout-out to the Pi Network community. They're making some great progress with their Linux node support and their new App Studio. It's always exciting to see new and innovative projects taking shape in the open-source world. And that is a wrap. What a week, right? From a brand new OS from KDE to some major kernel updates and a ton of new features in our favorite distros, there's never a dull moment in the world of Linux. What do you think about all this news? Are you excited about KDE Linux? Are you going to try out the new Linux Mint 22.2? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.